Regarding aesthetic restorative materials, silicates were dominantly used in the first half of the 20th century. As silicates severely eroded and had poor wear resistance, they were replaced by acrylic resins, predominantly polymethyl methacrylate, but they showed excessive polymerization, shrinkage, thermal expansion and contraction. These problems were countered by addition of quartz powder as fillers. But they were only partly successful as filler lacked bonding to the surrounding resin material. In 1962, Bowen developed a new type of composite material that included resin bis-GMA instead of PMMA as matrix, filler and a coupling agent to bind both filler and bis-GMA. This type of composite material largely overcame all the mentioned above difficulties. Moving on to the classification of dental composites currently in use, it is classified based on filler particle size, based on matrix composition, based on polymerization method, based on viscosity. Based on filler particle type, we have homogeneous, heterogeneous and hybrid composites. Homogeneous are mainly macrofill, midifill, minifill, microfill, nanofill, megafill. Whereas based on matrix composition, we have either bis-GMA based composites or UDMA based composites. Based on polymerization method, we have light cure, chemical cure or dual cure composites. Based on viscosity, we have packable composite or flowable composites. Now, let us see in detail about the components of the composite, which will give a clearer idea regarding the classification. The dental composites mainly have three major components: matrix, filler and coupling agent, as we saw earlier. Moving on to the matrix, matrix is mainly bis-GMA or UDMA. Bis-GMA stands for bisphenol A glycidyl dimethacrylate or UDMA urethane dimethacrylate. They usually form a highly cross-linked, strong, rigid and durable polymer structure. This matrix forms a continuous phase in which the reinforcing filler particle is dispersed. UDMA and bis-GMA both have high viscosity, and to facilitate more blending and manipulation, low molecular weight, highly fluid monomers such as TEGMA, triethylene glycol dimethacrylate, is also added. The second main component being filler, they are employed to strengthen and reinforce composites as well as to reduce curing and shrinkage and thermal expansion. They include mainly soft glass, borosilicate hard glass, fused quartz, aluminium silicate, lithium aluminium silicate, or they can be barium, strontium, zirconium, zinc glasses. The main function of fillers include reinforcement. By increased filler loading generally increases physical and mechanical property of the composite, reduction of the polymerization, shrinkage or contraction, then reduction in thermal expansion and contraction, then control of the viscosity or workability of the composite, decreased water sorption and imparting radio opacity to the composite. The most commonly used glass filler is barium glass. Moving on to the third main component, coupling agent, it is essential that the filler particles be bonded to the resin matrix. These materials which are used as coupling agent were earlier titanates and zirconates. Now recently, organosilanes such as gamma, methacryl, oxypropyl, trimethoxysilane are most commonly used. Apart from these three main components of the dental composite, we have other three minor components which include activation initiation system, inhibitor and optical modifiers. The activator initiation system is based on whether it is a chemically curable, that is self-cure resin, or a light cure resin. It can also be sometimes dual cure resin. The chemically activated resin is usually supplied as two-phase system, one which contains benzyl peroxide initiator and the other aromatic tertiary amine activator. When both are mixed, addition polymerization sets in. Photochemically activated light cure resin, earlier formulated for UV light to initiate free radicals. Today, UV light cured composites have been replaced by visible blue light activated systems. Camphorquinone is a commonly used photosensitizer that absorbs blue light with wavelengths between 400 to 500 nanometer. The inhibitor commonly added is butylated hydroxytoluene, BHT. The inhibitors have two functions: to extend the resin's storage life and to ensure sufficient working time. Optical modifiers are usually added for natural appearance to imitate enamel and dentin. Shading is achieved by adding various pigments, usually consisting of minute amounts of metal oxide particles. To increase opacity, the manufacturer adds titanium dioxide or aluminium oxide. Thus, in this video, we have seen about what are composites, what do they contain, the classification commonly used to classify composites. In further videos, we'll deal about what is acid etching, what is dentin bonding system, and how do we usually place composite in a cavity. Please be subscribed to get updates on when videos are being uploaded.